epiphyte. This is epiphyte. The epiphytic plant shows repeated branching. It has repeatedly branching to form a many branches. These all are the branches. It is growing as a epiphyte. It is a small size of prothallus. The prothallus goes to repeatedly branches. Now the surface of the branch has bears sexual organs. Antheridium and archegoniums are erosus on the apexes of that branches. Generally these branches are colorless. So it has again mycorrhiza. The mycorrhiza collecting humus on decaying bark, because it growing on the plant trunks, woody trunks. The rhizoids are absorbing collection of humus and minerals on the decaying bark. This is the Lycopodium phlegmaria type 3. It is also perennial, colorless. So the first one is annual, second one is perennial, third one is perennial. These all are the prothallus, means juvenile gametophytes. Before formation of sexual organs, they are called prothallus. If they produce complete matured sexual organs, now it is called gametophyte. Generally, we are saying either prothallus or gametophyte. Both are applied in condition. Now, sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction. In sexual reproduction, two sex organs are involving. One is antheridium, another one is archegonium. Antheridium and archegonium both are embedded in tissue. There is no stalk. There is no clear venter. So these antheridium and archegonium both are embedded in tissue. Means gametophyte. So the antheridium has jacket. The entire antheridium origin from antheridial incial, single cell, this one. The antheridial incial to produce as complete antheridium. It is jacket, these are lid cells, number of cells are 2. These are androcyte mother cells. Every androcyte mother cell goes to oblique division to form a androcytes, 2 androcytes. Every androcyte is oval shaped with 2 long biplasellated. So biplasellated androcytes are origin from the antheridium. When matured, the lid cells are opened, they are released into surrounding water, they can swim. Then archegonium. The entire archegonium origin from archegonial incial. Here the archegonium embedded in gametophytic tissue. The archegonium has jacket. It is the neck jacket. These are the neck canal cells. Nearer, 4 to 8 neck canal cells are present. Remember, 4 to 8 neck canal cells. 4 lid cells. 1 ventral canal cell. 1 egg cell. Here, no venter. The entire venter almost embedded into gametophytic tissue. So it is egg cell, big in size. The number of neck canal cells are 4 to 8. Ventral canal cell is 1, lid cells are 4. When matured archegonium, before the fertilization, these all neck canal cells are go to disintegrated along with ventral canal. These all cells are go to disintegrated to form mucilage and releases one chemical, that is citric acid. So the citric acid attract to the androcyte. So the androcytes are attracting to this chemical. This movement is called chemotactic movement. When the androcyte moves forward towards the archegonium, finally it passes along the neck and finally fused with egg to form fertilization, to form a zygote or embryo. The embryo formation takes place at venter of archegonium. That fertilization is called chemotactic fertilization. The chemical name is citric acid. The number of the canals, neck canal cells are 4 to 8. Now the egg is formed at winter. Now this is the zygote. Zygote goes to division, and after one more division, quadrant stage, and after octant stage, 8-cell stage, and finally produces sporophyte. The upper quadrant cells produces stem and leaf. The lower quadrant produces rhizoids. So finally the complete sporophyte is formed. So the sporophyte and gametophyte come alternately. Such type of life cycle is called heteromorphic lifestyle. Heteromorphic lifestyle appear in Lycopodium species. Thank you.